No, ain't no cap in it. I like with a stack in it. I'm bout it, I'm bout it. Stop it, cause it ain't no acting it. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. Leaving my mark like a. I see no biggie. Call me Hillary, stay at the bank. Making moves like I'm hot in the shank. I'm low key, but I pop out in blank. This bun on my knife, I'm trying to look. They do not cover me. Fake, I can't keep no company. Only the real respect, my honest. So watch how you coming if y'all under me. I'm with it and wrecks involved. All that text and calls. And run me that. Making no sense at all. That bounce like a basketball. Your boo never coming back. This girl stupid, go dumb. Told that boy you gotta pay for some. I sit on no palm, you ain't taking none. You bragging on pants, I make for fun. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. You mad while I'm getting busy. Country girl running your city. Attitude bad off the ditty. He only two times in the out like a lat, call him Ricky. And honestly, it ain't no cap in it. These know ain't no cap in it. I like with a stack in it. I'm bout it, I'm bout it. Stop it, cause it ain't no acting it. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. Leaving my mark like a. I see no biggie.
We are about 10 miles or so southwest of downtown Los Angeles at SoFi Stadium in Inglewood.
Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the San Francisco 49ers and the Los Angeles Chargers. Northern California visits Southern California. The Niners and Chargers, off we go from L.A.
Pulls it in at the 13.
The Niners take over first down 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Lance. And that throw behind his man. He missed him. Incomplete.
I think we'll see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
To throw again on second down. Lance. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 18 yards, first down Niners. Shotgun now for Lance. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. On play action, Lance. Lines up and lets it go for Samuel.
And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A big play there for the Niners. And even 40 yards.
Execution was one of their watchwords leading up to this one. And on that play, able to execute brilliantly here on this opening drive.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And his throw is incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Now former six-round pick, it's Elijah Mitchell. And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line. is Lance on third down.
This is caught and stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Wow, that's a big conversion there on third down, and this has been a great opening drive. You know, at this point, they'd hate to settle for three, but they've created a fresh set of downs and a first and goal.
Mitchell will get into the end zone for a 49er touchdown.
That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts a defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
They're going to keep it on the ground. And he will get in to make it 8-0.
So what do you make of that? You go on the road, you score the opening drive touchdown, opt to go for two, and all of a sudden they're up 8-0.
Yeah, this wasn't a decision that they made right here and right now. They made this decision during the week. Hey, if we get the ball and score right away, let's show them that we feel like we're superior. Go for two and really put the pressure on them.
Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They started on the ground with Eckler, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Herbert now. He'll find Everett there, complete. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. And the Niners get there and bring him down. Here we go on fourth. Herbert. That's going to be complete to his tight end, Everett. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 21 yards there. A big play on fourth down. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try to keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Herbert. And this is caught. First catch for Keenan Allen. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Again, Herbert. That's complete to the tight end, Everett. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. On first and 10, Herbert. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked by Emmanuel Mosley. And the 49ers are going to get the football here at their own 23. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball is tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
Now a play fake. Lance. This will be caught. It's Samuel. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First down, here's Mitchell. And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it. It's second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A good pick up there, 26 yards. One quarter down, 8-0 the score. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Off of play action, and here's Lance. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. So second and long, you've got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Another try after the first down sack. Lance, he's got the hook up to McLeod. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. Third and long, they'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
Lance and company going on fourth down. And able to haul it in is Kittle. And he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. Wow, first and goal, and defensively all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well.
Lance looks to throw again.
That is caught by the tight end, Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the 49ers have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Gold with the extra point, and the lead is up to 15 now.
Niners 15, Chargers nothing. Robbie Gold to kick off for San Francisco.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away.
And Carter deciding not to bring this one out.
The Charger drive about to get going.
Charles, it's kind of gut check time. Look, I know it's early first quarter, just their second drive of the game, but they've already thrown the interception, given up the score. You're down double digits. They got to figure out something, and pretty quickly here.
No doubt about it. And when we look at that sideline, I'm sure you're observing the same thing I am. I don't like the body language at all. They look like they're in a state of stunned disbelief. So to me, we always talk about someone stepping up and making a big play. I think it would behoove them if multiple guys step up and make big plays right now. They need something positive to happen, and they need for it to happen now. I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play, but sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Justin Herbert looking to pass. And he comes back with one complete. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle. But they allow the conversion.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you're dealing with basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Herbert.
He'll drop this one off to Eckler.
And he is going to lose yardage here. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. Looking to throw again on second down. Herbert trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line.
So rare to see any quarterback toss back-to-back interceptions in the NFL, regardless of status or experience. Whether it's him personally or just the offensive game plan, I think this defense is reading something out there, and they're holding the upper hand.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by J.C. Jackson. And the Chargers are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
The Charger drive about to get going. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week? Not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern a little bit. Whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
The play fake to Eckler. It's Herbert.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Dre Greenlaw getting home on that one.
These sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles. And that front seven defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out because the entire game he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance. They've got to get the ball out of his hands a lot quicker.
And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
Not much going on this drive. Looks like they're going to have to punt it away, CD.
And right now, I know a lot of their fans are screaming for the OC to change things up, get away from what he's been calling. Sometimes you just need better execution of the plays that have been called.
On Herbert, his third interception.
And into the end zone, a pick six for the 49er D as they score the touchdown. Gold to add the extra point. And the lead opens up now to 22 points.
Makes the score Niners 22, Chargers nothing.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away.
DeAndre Carter now from his end zone. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14.
At their own 14-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and it finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line.
Well, CD, you know, when you mentioned earlier about spreading the ball around in this game, I don't think you mentioned the guys in the other uniform. With four interceptions here in the first half, and several different guys have picked him off.
Yeah, instead of analyzing what's going wrong with him, throwing the football, while we look at the defense, they came in prepared. Had excellent game plan, well scouted, and they're taking it away at almost every turn.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle. That's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Lance now to throw. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position.
Oh, they pitch to the tight end. It's a fake. They're not going to get it. They try to move the chains with a surprise, but it's a turnover on downs. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back.
I'm just going to go ahead and call it, partner. You could smell the desperation in that fake, couldn't you? Down big, they had to try something. No one was fooled.
You're exactly right. With this deficit, though, go ahead and give it a shot. Didn't work out. In the end, I guess it doesn't hurt too much. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Rolling to his right. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway.
And with only 9 seconds remaining, with not much time, we'll see how they play this.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one.
Here we go. Back, back, back.
A final shot before half for Lance. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Both these teams, no doubt, making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Gunn and Charles Davis.
And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. But gutsy call there. Yanks at the locker room with a lead, trying the onside kick. It didn't work.
And you just wonder what the gain was there. They're already in the lead. They were in control of the game. They may have given momentum now to their opponent and maybe kickstarted things going in the opposite direction.
Of play action. Oh, he put it on the carpet, a fumble. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
Well, if these guys wanted to get back in this game, they needed an almost perfect second half, and down 3 scores, a lost fumble here certainly doesn't fit into that plan.
That reminds me of my plan in college to get an A on the papers I turned in, but that didn't work out too well either. Too many mistakes by both of us. I mean, that's just pure and simple. And that's why that's exactly where they are in this ball game. They're going to need a huge turnaround if they want to try and win this one.
2 yards on the pickup there, and it's second down.
brings up second and eight. At the 20-yard line.
Now Lance. And returns it right back to Samuel.
A big play there for the Niners. 55 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flipped field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
The Lance going to throw. That's caught by Debo Samuel. Touchdown, San Francisco. A 5-yard touchdown catch. And the 49ers are able to capitalize on the forced fumble by turning it. Oh, and now they're going to fake it.
The touchdown all set up by the big play one snap before, but they finish it off here with a shorter completion, this time for the score.
I like how they stuck with what got them there, right? The big pass play. Got the momentum going, right? That's you create it with a play like that, and you come right back with another pass play to finalize things off.
And this will not work out. The Chargers able to recover. The risk for more of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play. And here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything, because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them. And field position leads you to that type of play calling. And whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on second and 13. Out of the gun, Herbert. Out left, he's got it to Everett. And he'll be brought down just shy of 40. From the gun, Herbert on third down. And now here is another interception. And the Niners are going to get the football here at their own 40-yard line.
I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now five times?
It's beyond stunning to me, because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ballgame, I would have said never. Not in a million years, but here we go.
It's a gain of 35.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in for second-half blowout material.
Now a throw here to his running back. Down inside the 10, and they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3.
Here's Lance to throw it.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
They'll go again from the 3 here on second and goal. Again, they'll throw it with Lance. They'll find Ayuk open right side. So back-to-back plays, each get nothing. And that will go to a third and goal.
Shot, 17. Light blue.
Here's Lance. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Nasir Adderley, and the Chargers are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. But to be blunt, not a whole lot has gone right for this defense in this ballgame, but that's something right there, still in the third quarter. It would take something around miracle territory for a comeback, but maybe that's a start, Charles.
It certainly is, and they're definitely showing that there's some fight still left in them. Hasn't been a banner day. They're trying their best to put that disappointment behind them and find ways to make plays.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers both on the sidelines and in the huddle looking at each other.
To throw on second and 10. Herbert. And my goodness, another interception. picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
What a nightmarish game he's having now. Six interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it. But it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown six interceptions in the game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it three times.
I'll give them credit winning that first snap and forcing an incompletion. They're hoping that'll deflate the offense a little bit after they took the field charged up after taking over after a turnover.
Back to the air on second down. It's Lance. Now Lance throws the interception, his third, picked off by J.C. Jackson. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
The Charger drive about to get going. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
And now Herbert a little unsure of things, so he's going to go ahead and call a timeout. And with that, they're down to one remaining here in the second half. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Herbert now. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Charvarius Ward. The number seven, usually lucky here. Not for him. Seven picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened six times since 1960.
And I know that the most recent time it happened, the guy who threw him, he had won a Heisman Trophy in college, so sometimes you just have a lousy game. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad career. But when you're talking about one game, seven, you're right, not lucky at all.
Yeah, Ty Detmer, the last to do it in 2001 to throw seven picks. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today.
Picked off by Asante Samuel Jr.
And the Chargers are going to get the football here at their own 23. Well, the deep ball has been a big factor in why they have the lead that they do, but here this defense finally said, hey, enough's enough.
Yeah, and obviously they've had their struggles all game long. Now, this won't make up for the deficit that they already face, but it is something that they can finally feel good about.
The Charger drive about to get going. That's a game that they would rather probably forget about, at least to this point. Herbert has it knocked free.
And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And he will bring this one back. It's a fumble return for the 49er touchdown. Second time he's lost a fumble. This one hurts more. It's returned for six.
He's been under a lot of duress, hasn't he? Pressured, hurried, harassed the whole game.
Well, the offensive line not giving him a lot of help.
Not a lot of help, but the bottom line, he's got to take care of the football.
And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. So, boy, that's all.